So, the title is kind of clickbaity. Seeing from the number of people that is here, clearly ops is not dead. Ops is just has just changed, and it has changed a lot over the years. But what I'm going to talk about is something that pops up so many times in conversations among friends and people that don't do DevOps, and that's kind of a couple of ideas that I want to share with you. I'm 39. I'm Carlos. I'm 39 years old, so I'm getting older. I started out wanting to be a programmer, then ended up doing system administration for more than 10 years. I still do it sometimes, and I've been doing software development full time, or for most part of it, for the last 5 years. And I always believe that a good sysadmin must know how to program. This is a thing that has never changed. It's not a new thing. Sysadmins should always have had to know how to program. So, development and operations has always been a kind of a war, or at least it deteriorates into a war, because there is always different, often conflicting focus. Operations wants to put things like having things under control and things working, and development wants to change things. These two sides always attracted people with different interests. Developers like to focus more, I think, on the abstract thing, part of coding and writing code and algorithms, and operations type people tend to like more like stuff that is working and that's being perfected while working. But these sides, although they have sometimes conflicting goals, they always required proper communication and mutual understanding to do to so that the overall goals of the organization got met. This has always been it's made easier by having some overlapping knowledge, like sysadmins knowing how to program and programming, in fact, at least a part of their time, and developers knowing what's underneath their applications, where the applications end up running. And this is kind of it's where things have been evolving. That's why DevOps is a thing, and that's a good thing. But in the past, all this good to have, like happy, everybody talking to everybody involved in the process, many cases got buried under kind of tribal wars, people getting sunk into their silos for some reason or another. So I think currently both approaches remain necessary. You need people that are 10 in that tend to focus on the stability side of things and people that tend to focus on the changing part of things. It's very hard to put those two things in the same people. Having someone with those two goals doesn't lead to, I think, in practice, to good results. You need balance. You need two people at least to kind of have the different views. So it's very hard. I think the challenge is to, when you are planning kind of a DevOps strategy, I think it's the challenge is how do you avoid having just devs or just ops? And from kind of informal conversations and speaking to people, it's funny that sometimes we hear or I hear kind of this idea that we don't actually need ops nor DevOps. We actually don't even need ops at all. We need no ops. We just need devs. And I think that if you are a small startup, if you're just starting, have a small team, have just a single product, you can get away with just the same team doing everything and having the two conflicting objectives in the same in the same people. But eventually you need to kind of start slowly specializing, But as you know, startups tend to kind of go bankrupt, so many of them never actually get to the point where they figure that out. And but that, this idea of no ops, I think, comes from some wrong beliefs. I think sometimes you hear people saying, yeah, well, I'm going to the cloud, I'm moving everything to the cloud, and the cloud provider manages the databases, everything for me, I use cloud services, etc., so I don't need anyone to manage everything. The devs can just deploy, and things will just run, and then nothing bad will ever happen, and, well, you just need the developers. Also, this also comes from not knowing what the operation parts of an organization should do. I think that's historically been kind of the operations people's fault, I think, by not being too communicative and stuff. And I think also because of coming from wrong beliefs about what operations should do, because the past is the past. Operations in the past were operations in the past. Now we don't do the things in the same way today, but there are still a role to be played by people that like operations. And that final point there is kind of what I feel it mostly, which is I am 39 years old. When I started working, we kind of had more computation near to us. We saw hardware, actual hardware. I went into computing because I like computers. Stuff that runs on computers, not stuff that something runs somewhere. There is a growing separation between computation and computation devices. Everything goes to the cloud. The cloud is somewhere. You don't see anything of it. You just see interfaces that many times simulate a real infrastructure. If that's a good idea, that remains to be seen. I think it's that simulation is kind of disappearing as well. So this makes me kind of grumpy, this idea of we don't need operation, we don't need ops. The devs can do everything. This makes me grumpy. So looking into the future, I think what options will people like me that love infrastructure have? Should they kind of jump ship and switch to dev or just give up? I did that in a way, but I do infrastructure still today, and I've never stopped doing it. But what options will systems-loving people have in the future? Will they kind of, if they want to do hardcore operation stuff, will they only get interesting work in kind of the big cloud providers, whereas everything else is just done by people that love to develop software? And will there be any chance to interact with actual hardware or not? Will there be kind of reversal of the everything to the cloud, and at some point we went too far, and some things come back or not? Will computer plumbing become uncool? Will programmers still know how TCP works? Will any DevOps person still know how the TCP works? Will anybody still get excited by doing IPsec stuff, or they be like ashamed to talk about it? Like, I configured the IPsec VPN, but I'm kind of ashamed of doing it. Or is it already uncool? Do we see talks about low-level infrastructure stuff in conferences? Are people avoiding doing this kind of talks? Will people be interested? People non-infrastructure people, is this still attractive? Speaking about these kind of subjects. And well, things are changing. Will any of the things that I said actually matter? Will we care? Will I care? In like 20 years or 30 years, I'll be retired. Will I care if things don't change too much until there? So kind of, I'll leave you with this question, and that's it. Thank you.